Hey guys, Michelle Glass here. Our job for today is to look at the spinal cord. We are looking here at a cross-sectional view. To begin, let's take a look at the outside of the spinal cord. Notice that the blood vessels are intact there, just like they are on this brain model here. So where you have a brain or spinal cord structure that has blood vessels on the outside, that tells us that the pia mater is still intact. That's our innermost meningeal layer, which is helping to anchor those blood vessels, and it's attaching into the neural tissue. It's very thin, transparent tissue, so you can't see it as a layer by itself. Think of it sort of as like saran wrap holding those arteries and veins to the brain or the spinal cord. The next thing we want to do is to look for the depressions. And we have, remember, our deep depression on the front. This is our anterior median fissure. At the back, we have a smaller depression or more shallow called the posterior median sulcus. So that's how we know the front from the back. Then let's take a look at the center of the spinal cord. You see what maybe looks like a butterfly. That's our collection of gray matter. At the center of the gray matter, you have a passageway called the central canal that contains the cerebrospinal fluid. On either side of the gray matter, on either side of the central canal, connecting the left and right sides together, you have what's called the gray commissure, and that's spelled with two M's and two S's. Okay, then we have what's called the anterior gray horn, lateral gray horn, and posterior gray horn. Next, turn your attention to the white matter surrounding that. We're gonna divide it into columns. So you have anterior white column, lateral white column, posterior white column, and then on either side of the gray commissure, you have a white commissure. And again, that's spelled with two M's and two S's. Okay, then this side's broken, so let's take a look over here. We have right here what's called the spinal nerve. You have 31 pair of spinal nerves branching off of your spinal cord. They're named based on the vertebrae that they are next to. Now you actually have 8 cervical spinal nerves because you have one above C1 and then another pair below C1. Then you have your 12 thoracic, 5 lumbar, 5 sacral, and 1 coccygeal. So you have 31 pairs of spinal nerves. So that's what we see right here. Each spinal nerve is composed of an anterior root and a posterior root. Notice your posterior root has this bulge that's called the spinal ganglion, which is the singular version, ganglia, with an IA ending is plural. So we know the front because of the anterior median fissure, and we know the back because of that posterior root with that spinal ganglia. When your two roots, anterior root, posterior root, come together to form your spinal nerve, you then get branches off of the spinal nerve. So each of those branches is named a ramus, which is the singular version of the word. Rami is plural, and it really just means branch. And these are named for direction. So you have a posterior ramus, anterior ramus, and then these together are called the rami communicants. And that's it.